So first of all, thank you so much to the Mainline TV and to Logan and Kevin for coming today. They're going to be with us for probably 3 hours. Today is the competition. We have two very distinguished musicians that are judging. One of them is Daniel Schlossberg from New York, and he drove here, and he's director and founder of an opera company. And the other judge is Tamara Rusanova, who came a little bit farther than New York City, a little bit farther. She came all the way from Moscow 2 years ago, and her son had the foresight to buy her tickets 2 days after the Ukraine war started, when Russia invaded Ukraine. And she's with us for the past 2 years. She has been teaching her students. She's a professor of a competing conservatory called the Gnesin East Institute, competing with the Moscow Conservatory. And some of the greatest pianists studied there, including Eugene Kissin.
I'm really happy that Elena asked me to judge this competition. When I was young and studying at the Nellie Berman School, I played in a few competitions, and just driving here now, I got the same butterfly feeling that I used to when I was a child. So I understand that these 28 students will be, you know, performing like I did 20 years ago. It's really amazing to kind of be on the other side of this. As I said, I was one of these contestants 20 years ago. So we're going to hear them play mostly Baroque music. We'll definitely listen for musicianship. I think first for me personally, that's the most important. See how they create a phrase, a musical phrase in this style. And technique, of course, and intonation if they're not a pianist. But for me, it's really overall musicality that I'm looking for. And I'm sure they're going to be fantastic. I cannot wait to hear them.
Thank you. old are you?
Eight.
She's eight. And what grade are you in?
Second
grade. Did you like the piece that you were playing?
Yeah.
You played it with so much energy and so much musicality. Do you think that it reminds you of something? Is there like a story or a picture that you see here when you play this piece?
Kind of like the Fantasia that they made on Disney.
Ah, this is true. You've seen the Disney Fantasia? So which part is? Because there was the part about the sorcerer apprentice, right? There was a sorcerer apprentice and with
the little Pegasus.
What is it?
The little Pegasi flying in the air.
So this is somebody flying in the air, I see. Do you feel like you were flying? Yourself? How would you fly? Like this? Yes? were you nervous when you were playing?
A little bit?
But you had so much energy. You were really up in the air. We felt it like this. So how long have you been playing this piece?
Maybe for a year.
For a year? 1 year. So it's been a long time, right? Have you played any other pieces besides this piece?
And I finished the second and third movement.
Of the same concerto? So you play actually the whole concerto. I would love to hear it. We have performance classes at the Nelly Berman School every Saturday, and students sign up when they have something ready to play. And Charlotte came and played this, I think, twice she already played. So I think this is the third time. So students, any student, it could be a beginner, more advanced, older, younger, I would love to hear you play second and third movement. Yes, I'm excited to hear it. You play beautifully and you look gorgeous, just like those flowers next to you. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
She's a student at Wolven, and when she came in, I met with her, like I meet with all of our incoming students, to see who would be the right teacher for them. And I really saw her incredible musicality, and I knew that Dr. Anna Kislitsina would be just the right teacher. And what she has done in the last few months that she's been studying here is extraordinary. How old are you?
I'm 14 years old.
And what grade are you?
I'm in ninth grade.
Ninth grade, so several years. Is this your first competition or you competed before?
So I've competed a few times before, but most of them were virtual auditions.
Virtual, so first in life. You're actually seeing people.
Yeah.
Have you ever played Bach before?
So not for a competition, no. This is my first time ever playing a Bach concerto, and it's also my first time being accompanied by someone in a competition.
And what did you think about learning this movement? It's
I
a slow
it.
Movement.
Yeah, yes. I have never actually competed with a slower piece before, so it was a very nice experience to be able to really put more emotion into a piece instead of just having very fast, very speedy piece.
Can I ask you, it's a strange question. Some musicians feel music emotionally, but have a hard time describing their emotions. Is there some image or an emotion or visual image that you see when you're playing this music, or it's very hard to describe? I know music sometimes can describe some emotions that we cannot describe in words. Are there any words that you can describe this music?
I would call this piece grave or solemn. It's a very slow, sad kind of piece. Mm-hmm. The right hand reminds me of like a very pretty like song, like something that you might hear in a church when you're mourning someone, so. Mm-hmm.
Do you have any images?
Probably like a chapel.
Chapel. Mm-hmm. Okay. Thank you so much.
Yeah, thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. I grew up playing the piano, and it was, you know, it was my thing. Growing up, it was my passion. Music still is my passion. And I chose not to go to conservatory. I chose to go to a, you know, to a university. And the university was a great experience for me. I played with an orchestra there. I played with a few orchestras before the university, and I did a lot of chamber music. And my wife, Claudine, and I, we have three great kids, Yoni, Ellie, and David. You saw Yoni and David, not Ellie. Yoni plays the violin, Ellie plays the piano. David plays both the violin and the piano because he's the youngest one and wants to be like his two older siblings. And music's a big part of our lives and of our kids' lives.
Bach D minor concerto,
which is the first concerto by Bach.
Yes, the calls first. J.S. Bach, famous concerto, the Baroque concerto for keyboard that we know. But apparently, his son Carl Philipp Emanuel Bach wrote it first with a lighter version, and then the father Johann Sebastian Bach took it and improved it. So, and as of today, this is what we go by. It's J.S. Bach, but it's actually really Carl Philipp Emanuel Bach who wrote plain version.
So this is like in the Bible, honor your parents.
That's right. That's right. That's right. So. Thank you.
I've been living in New York now for about 10 years since graduating from Yale for grad school. I got my doctorate in composition and I've studied piano throughout. I have an opera company in New York called Heartbeat Opera that I'm the music director of, and I perform as a pianist all over regularly, and I conduct and compose. So I'm fully a freelance musician. So I grew up here on the Main Line. I went to Lower Merion High School, and I really owe my musical development to the Nellie Berman School of Music. When we moved here from Ohio when I was about 9 years old, I took a lesson with Nellie and Elena, and I think the first thing they said to me was, he's very talented, but he has a lot of work to do. And so from then on, I really studied very hard with them. I practiced a lot. When I was 9 years old, practicing 2 hours a day felt like too much. But they persisted and I did as well. And I had an incredible time studying here throughout high school and really owe my musical professional life to the school.
She played the flute. And Hanya, how old are you?
11.
You're 11. And what grade are you in?
Six.
So how old were you when you started playing the flute?
I was about 8 years old.
About 8 years old. Now, I know you also played the piano, but flute was the one that you wanted to focus more on, yes? Mm-hmm. Have you ever played the baroque? before?
I don't think so.
Is that first time? Do you find this piece different than the pieces that you played before?
Yeah.
In what way?
Well, there are faster notes and the mood is a little different.
Mm-hmm. Did you find it more difficult or less difficult than the pieces you played before?
More difficult.
More difficult. So what's more difficult about this particular piece?
The speed,
because it requires a lot of technique. Do you think that you learned something from this? Like, if you would, I'm sure you learned something. But what do you think you learned from the experience of preparing for this competition?
I improved my tone and I learned better breathing techniques.
Wow, that's wonderful. Okay. Thank you so much. Piano and violin, and she loves music. She does many other things. Chloe, what else do you do besides violin and piano?
I also do ballet.
How do you divide the time between three things, ballet, violin, and piano? How do you find the time?
I just try to get my schoolwork done as fast as I can, and I try to avoid doing things like scrolling on my phone when I should be practicing.
What was the reason for you to choose both instruments?
I originally started playing the piano, but I saw Lindsay Sterling playing the violin, and that really inspired me to play the violin as well. I just really enjoy the sound of the violin.
How old are you?
I'm 16.
16, so what grade are you in?
10th grade.
10th grade, so 10th, 11th, 12th, she has 3 years. Do you think in college, or do you think of college continuing to do music?
Maybe as with the peers in my school, but I don't think I'm pursuing a minor or anything.
Uh-huh. What about your interest outside of music and ballet, the arts? Do you have any other interests academically?
Writing. I was briefly considering being a journalist, but I think I'm more towards being a lawyer now.
Oh, okay, well, isn't it nice to have a lawyer who loves music and ballet? We are safe hands with young people like this. Thank you, Chloe.
Thank you so much. Thank you. Thank you.
To hear children play on such a high level and then figure out that they're regular kids and they have other interests besides music, but then they do music on such a high level. So Emma, how old are you?
I'm 10.
And what grade are you in?
I'm in fifth grade.
Fifth grade. And have you played Bach before?
Well, I played some shorter Bachs, but this is the longest and most difficult I've played.
How did you... This is one of the most difficult piece you played, right? Yeah. The most difficult. What does it mean difficult for you?
Well, it took a lot of, like, hard work and more time to prepare. Like, for example, another one, it was, like, Prelude. It was shorter and it only took a couple weeks. But this one, it took, like a couple months.
How many months do you remember?
Like 3 to 4.
3 to 4 months. And how did you memorize this? How do you memorize in general? Like this piece, it's a very difficult and complicated piece. How did you memorize it?
Well, I memorized it in parts. Like I did like, let's say a couple lines and then some other ones. And then I like sections basically.
Did you like this piece?
Yeah, it's very musical.
It's very interesting. Do you think of any images or stories when playing this piece?
Well, I think of people, like, so when Jesus died, it was like Mary kind of crying in a way.
Very beautiful. What else do you like besides music? Do you have any other things, or music is it?
Well, I play tennis.
Tennis.
Yeah.
How much time do you spend practicing every day? Approximately. I'm sure there are days that you play tennis and then you play practice less. Approximately.
An hour to an hour, like 15 minutes.
Oh, wonderful. It was very beautiful. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Thank you.
This is Kanye Mellon, our clarinet student. And how old are you, Kanye?
I'm 16.
Kanye won some competitions. If you can tell us about it, what exactly are the honors and accolades that you recently received?
For PMEA is a local like music competition that runs through the school music programs. And I placed first in the District 11 audition and have made it to both the region band and orchestra. And hopefully I can make it to state orchestra when that region orchestra.
The state of Pennsylvania?
Yeah.
Oh, so this is your next goal. When are you auditioning for the state?
I think it's mid-March, like March 20th, I think.
And what are you supposed to play for this competition?
It's
orchestral music.
Yeah.
Are you allowed to play Mozart?
No, they'll ask, they give us an equalizer or some, it's just, they choose excerpts for the auditions as well. Mm-hmm. We're at the regional orchestra concert, we're playing Elgar's Enigma variations, mm-hmm. which is going to be fun.
How many lessons a week do you have, Kenny?
I have 2 lessons a week. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
2 hours, right?
Yep.
Right.
2 hours a week.
And how old were you when you really decided that clarinet was the instrument that you loved and that you wanted to pursue it with more seriousness?
I picked up clarinet when I was in fourth grade, but I only started like being more serious about music in the past year or two, mm-hmm. where I started practicing more and putting more effort in.
Yeah. We have several really incredible clarinet teachers. One of them, this is Kenny's teacher. His name is Alexander Bidienko, and he came from Ukraine many years ago, studied at Curtis, and then he played with number of top orchestras, including Philadelphia Orchestra. He was recently asked to substitute for a principal clarinet of Philadelphia Orchestra, New York Philharmonic. He played with Georgiev and the St. Petersburg Orchestra, and he's totally brilliant teacher, a young clarinetist, and I think with his coming to the Nellie Berman School, he truly like breathed life into your clarinet and your sound became so beautiful. And this piece you have been playing very shortly. How long have you been playing this movement? I know you played second movement before.
I played second movement.
How long were you working on this
movement? I only started like focusing on it for probably a month or so.
Yes, it's incredibly fast. fast. Right. Mm-hmm. Right. So that's a very short time,
yeah.
Right? Right. Well, it was. I love your playing, and I'm always touched by how musical you are.
Thank you
so much, and congratulations and good luck.
Thank you.
Thank you.
This is Sasha Murray, and she is a graduating senior. Sasha, where are you planning to go, and what are you planning to study next year?
I plan on studying computer science, and I'm not sure where I'm going to go yet. But
will you continue with music studies?
Yeah. Yes, I think I'll definitely continue, especially I want to do a lot of chamber music in college. But I probably won't be like double majoring, but
What about minor?
Maybe minor.
Great. Sasha is very, very busy, but she learned this incredibly difficult piece. And she also plays a Brahms sonata with her younger brother, Apollo Murray, who is a cellist, and she's a wonderful musician. Thank you.
Anna Kislitsina. She is a teacher of Sasha, and she has today 6 students who are playing Bach concertos, and from the very young children who are probably 9 years old, I think, Allison, to the oldest one today, Sasha, and I believe Daniel will be the next one. Can you please tell us how you feel about Baroque music?
Oh, I feel great. I'm so thankful that school and Yelena was able to arrange this competition, because Bach is very difficult and very important for younger generations, and having such focus to interpretations, to ornamentation in young ages, very challenging and at the same time very important. So we all enjoyed so much preparing for this performance, and I believe everybody grew up professionally so much by performing and by preparing for this event. Thank you so much.
Dr. Kislitsina came to the United States having been interested in romantic music and also in modern music. I believe her dissertation was on Misayan. And then while after she came, she did her doctorate at Temple University, and not only did she study classical music, but also harpsichord. And harpsichord is the, like I would say, passion sometimes in life. Later on in life, we get to love something incredibly. So she's a phenomenal harpsichord player. She performs a lot as a harpsichordist. And what is really interesting for her students is that she brings that knowledge of in Bach's music and Baroque music, of their ornamentation, knowledge of the specific style, and listening to her today, she's going to be accompanying her 6 students, and it's absolutely fascinating. She also plays the organ, so, a studied organ, so she's a Renaissance woman.
Thank you.
is a student at the Episcopal Academy, and I know that when he started studying at the school, at the beginning he was studying music sort of as a general education. His mother wanted him to explore music, but then I think they, both his mother and Daniel, decided they wanted to compete. So this is like a big thing for him. Have you participated in any other competition, Daniel?
Yeah, I have. I've participated a lot.
Okay. What does it mean for you to participate in this particular competition? Is it different, same?
Yeah, I think it's definitely different than a lot of the other competitions I did. I mean, Baroque music is not something that I've played a lot before. I've kind of done more romantic music. So it has been a very interesting experience for me to try Baroque music and to play in this format. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Wonderful. Thank you so much.
Tamara, tell us a little bit. I know Russian is the language that she tells us, please. What do you think about children competing, children who are not professional musicians? Daniel Schlossberg, who was our student, did become professional musician. Not too many students at our school. What do you think? Does music competitions help students in any way?
Для детей, которые не занимаются музыкой профессионально, вы имеете в виду? Во-первых, я считаю, что все дети должны заниматься.
She said all children must study music. All children, and either they would like to become professional or not.
Еще два предложения. Музыка дает совершенно другой взгляд на жизнь.
Music gives a totally different perspective on life.
Кроме того, это хорошее занятие музыкой, это залог успешности в жизни вообще.
And if you study music seriously, it helps in all possible ways of life.
Потому что музыка организовывает умение работать над собой, улучшать свои skills, воспитывает терпение и воспитывает взгляд на мир очень широкий. И высокий, и глубокий одновременно.
She says that music creates a totally different view on life. It allows students to develop very hard work ethic, time management, emotional sensitivity, and makes people look at life from the high to the low of what is possible.
I am really lucky that when my parents took me here for the first time and realized that I had a musical inclination, that they fully supported me, and that when I was 9 years old, my grandmother got me a subscription to the Metropolitan Opera. And so I would go with her, and I still, to this day, she's 95 in May, and we still go to the Metropolitan Opera together. So I really owe it all to my parents, my grandparents, and of course, the teachers here.